Hey everyone, welcome to another video. In this video, I'm gonna be ranking all my new makeup purchases. This is makeup that I've tried recently and I've been really testing it out, and I'm here to tell you which ones I liked and which ones I didn't. And yeah, I have quite a lot of products here in front of me. Can't wait to tell you about them. Let's get right into this video. So if you haven't been on my channel before, my name is Marley and I love making YouTube videos about makeup and beauty. I love trying out new makeup, I love keeping up with the new releases, but I also like to try older things and rediscover older favorites in my collection. So if that sounds good to you, then don't forget to subscribe. I usually upload about 2 to 3 videos a week and I would love to see you again on my channel. Listen, it has been raining all day, and when it rains in this house, it is so loud. It is incredibly loud. It's like it would be so hard for you to understand what I'm saying. It's because of the roof and the windows that we have that are like slanted. So when it rains, it's like really loud. So I've been waiting to film for a little bit and I hope I can get this done before it starts raining really loud again. But yeah, I'm gonna do my best. I'm gonna try. Let's start with the product that I liked the least. So the product that I liked the least this time around is this Coral Lights Blush and Highlighter Palette by Catrice. This one I was pretty positive about in my first impression. I wasn't like hating it. I was like, it's pretty cute. I don't know yet about it. I don't know yet if I love it, but I don't hate it. But after using it more and more, I just don't think that this is worth the money, especially because Catrice can do really good cheek products, but this just isn't it. The thing about this palette is that these highlighters are like fine. They're okay, they're pretty nice. I don't hate them. They give you quite a good glow. But then these blushes are so powdery, uneven, blotchy. They're kind of like chunky and dry, and I don't think this works really well on the cheeks. I really don't like the formula on these blushes, and those highlighters, they're nice, but they can't make up for that fact. And just every time I did my blush and highlight with this palette, it just looked really dry and patchy, and I just didn't really love it. Well, that's like under exaggerated. I kind of hated it, and I'm pretty sure I'm gonna be decluttering this one because I really didn't like this. I just think Catrice can do so much better, and every time I use this, it just didn't look good. In the first impression, I did one cheek with another product and one cheek with this product, and there it was a little bit hard to tell what was going on with it, if I liked it. But when I applied it to both my cheeks, I just really, really, really didn't like it. I wouldn't recommend this. It's like really softly pigmented, which can work for some people, but it is also really powdery and just doesn't look even on the cheeks. Okay, so the next thing that I really, really didn't like is actually also from Catrice. And usually I really, really like their cheek products, but this Sun Lover Glow Bronzing Powder, this was totally not what I was hoping for. This is really not what I was hoping it would be like. Let me tell you, I did try a lot of Catrice this month. A lot of the things here are Catrice, so naturally I'm gonna like some better than others. There are some Catrice products towards the top, but there are also just a few that I didn't like this time around. And most of these things are from their new update. This one is a bit older in their collection, but I was still pretty curious to find out if I would like this. This is kind of like the same story as that highlighter palette. It's dry, it's blotchy, it's hard to blend, it doesn't look even, and it has a really like big chunky glitter particles in here, which are really visible on the skin. I feel like other products don't blend really well on top of this one, and that also makes it a lot harder to use. It's not like if you put something on top that it's gonna fix this bronzer. No, this bronzer is gonna make that product look worse. And now that I'm thinking about it, maybe this should have been last. Maybe this should have been last, because at least with that blush palette, there were two highlights in there that I kinda liked. This is one where I'm like, I'm probably not gonna use it again. I'm probably not gonna keep this in my collection for long. It's just really not something that I like. It just didn't look good on my skin. It didn't look glowy. It just looked dry, with those chunky glitters, which I don't like at all. But both of these products, the blush palette and this bronzer, I wouldn't recommend them. Usually, really, I like a lot of the Catrice Cheek products. They do a lot of good products. I don't know what happened here. I don't know what they did here. I know they can do it, but it's not really like visible with these products. In the next spot, I put this 5-in-a-box palette by Catrice. I've been hearing pretty good things about these palettes, and so I thought, you know what, let's try one. I'm gonna try one, and they had some new color stories that looked pretty exciting. It looked a little bit different than what they had before. Before, they only had like really neutral eyeshadow palettes, and I thought, I want to try the formula, but maybe it's a bit too similar to things I already own. So they came out with this gray blue palette, and I was like, you know, I will try it, I will see if I like it. And I didn't like this one. I feel like the shimmers are really crumbly. They are so hard to apply evenly. A lot of fallout. I really, really didn't like the shimmer formula. Then the gray mattes in here, I thought were tough to blend. Really patchy. Tough to build up. I don't like working with these shadows. The end result is okay. If I really work for it, I can make it look okay, but I don't like putting in so much effort. Even for a little palette, affordable palette like this, I don't want to put in that effort. I have other makeup that I would rather use than this one. In the end, I just really didn't like this one. I do believe that it's possible that the other eyeshadow palettes in this range are better, and that these might just be the colors that they didn't nail in this range because they're a bit harder to formulate. It's a bit harder to make really nice, blendable, smooth gray mattes. I'm feeling like this is probably patchy because of the color, and probably those other eyeshadow palettes are better. I've heard pretty good things about them. I haven't really heard anyone else talking about this particular palette. This is the one called Blue Smoky Look. This just didn't work for me. I might in the future give another eyeshadow palette in this range a chance, but I didn't love this one. And I probably am not gonna use this again as well. I just really didn't like it. This formula, I really didn't. It was just so, so hard to work with. Next up, we have a product that I actually really liked at first and was really into at first, and I still like it. But there's an ingredient here which makes me break out, which I'm really sad about it because for the rest of it, I liked the product. But that is the Holiday Skin Serum Bronzer by Catrice, and this has coconut water in it. I didn't really realize when I bought it, but later when I started breaking out and I looked at this, if this could be something that had a role in that, and I saw the coconut water, I was like, okay, I get what's going on here. Apparently, they had to ruin this product with the one thing that for sure breaks me out. Yeah, I'm pretty disappointed in this product. I really, really liked it at first. It's easy to mix in with a cream or with your SPF, or just use it on its own and get a little bit of that tan glowy look to your skin without it looking too crazy. And I was using this for like a week straight, but then I began breaking out like crazy all over my face. I was breaking out, and then I stopped using this. It went away. I used it again to try it, and it came back. So this is pretty much an unusable product to me. But if I wouldn't break out from this, then I would definitely still be using this. And I would recommend it if you are someone who doesn't break out from coconut, because it's just a really affordable, nice product that kind of can make your skin a little bit more bronze looking without it looking too crazy, which I really like because I have an SPF that is a little bit on the white casty side. It can create quite a white cast. I really have to blend it in. And especially when I'm a bit more tan, now after the summer I'm a bit more tan, you can definitely see that difference. So I really like using this to kind of mix in with my SPF until I found out that I can't really use it. So this is a bummer, but it's more of a personal thing. What I do feel is that it didn't stay on that well. It does stay on, but if you like scratch your skin or rub your skin, then it is possible that you rub it off a little bit, that you scratch a little bit off. So you have to be careful that you don't like touch your skin too much, because then it can kind of fade. So that is something to keep into account. But I think with this product is worth it because it's so much more affordable than other options that have this similar result. So yeah, I would recommend it, but you just have to see for yourself if there's any ingredient in this that will maybe break you out or your skin is sensitive to. I have pretty sensitive skin. I have to be pretty careful with ingredients. And if I use a product on the daily, it really has to have the ingredients that don't irritate my skin. So that's just something that I am dealing with, but maybe you aren't. Maybe this is something for you. Next up, we have the Catrice. We're still talking about Catrice. Soon there will be something else. Soon there will be products from different brands. But this is the Catrice Vegan Collagen Lipstick. This is their new line. They have a few different shades. I got a light nude shade. I'm wearing it today. This lipstick is one that I can only really wear when my lips are not dry, because this shade does really emphasize like texture, dryness, dry patches, and it doesn't look good. So today I'm wearing it and my lips are feeling pretty hydrated. They're feeling pretty good and I feel like it looks a lot better. Still, it emphasizes texture, but it's not that crazy as when I had really dry lips. So I can kind of wear this. It does feel pretty like hydrating on the lips. It has a nice amount of pigmentation. I really like the color. It's just a tough lipstick to wear. I really have to be aware of what my lips are like that day. And that's kind of like turning me off from this lipstick. I do feel like other shades in this line will probably be nice because it does feel really nice and smooth and creamy on the lips. So I think if I would just buy a little bit of a deeper shade, that it will definitely work for me and that I will like it. I just chose the lightest shade to try out because I was feeling a little bit of a lighter nude and I do like the color. It's just I feel not the perfect color for this particular formula. So this is a lipstick that I don't love. I feel like it's like okay, I can work with it, I can be mindful of it, but I was expecting a little bit more and I would have loved it if I could wear this like any day, or at least most days. So that's what's going on with that lipstick. Next up, we have this Catrice. Maybe I should have called this a Catrice ranking. You know, when they update the line, I always buy a bunch of the new stuff to try out. It's just something I like to do on my channel and it's something I always think is fun. So yeah, I got a lot of their stuff. But this Catrice eyelash, what's it called? It doesn't say, but it's like the eyelash separator. You can use this after you've applied your mascara. You can use this comb. It looks like this. This is what the comb looks like. You can use this to separate your lashes. When I first tried it, I was like, that doesn't really work. But that was kind of like my fault because I use really, really dried out mascara. And of course, then it's pretty hard to separate your lashes because they are just so, so dry already. It's completely dry before you even go in with the lash separator. So that was kind of my fault. But I tried it again with a newer, fresher mascara that wasn't that dry. And it does work. It does separate your lashes. You have to be a bit careful that you don't poke your eye out. And you have to be a bit fast because it doesn't really work after your mascara has dried. I just don't really feel like I need this in my life because I like a little bit of a clumpiness to the lash. So it has a little bit more volume to it. But if you're someone who really struggles with clumpy lashes, doesn't really like the look of it, this can be something that you can use. I feel like this is a product that you don't use a lot. That I will just put with my brushes and then maybe someday I'll be like, okay, my lashes are looking so clumpy and I will just grab it and just separate them with it. But I don't think this is something that I need from a day to day on a daily basis. So it kind of depends on you. Maybe this is a product you were waiting for. Maybe this is something that you feel like you really need in your life. Maybe you are always struggling with separating your lashes. It could be, then this might be something for you. But for me, I don't feel like I really need it. Okay, from now on, we are talking about the makeup that I really like. The makeup that maybe isn't perfect, but generally I think is good and I would recommend. So the Next thing, the next spot goes to the Kiko Charming Escape eyeshadow palette. This one is in Greenview. This packaging of this Charming Escape collection by Kiko is so gorgeous. I love this outer box. If I could have this in like a fabric to make a dress, or if I could just have a dress in this particular print, I would love it. I would love that. I would want that. But okay, this is what the packaging of the palette looks like. It has a bunch of beautiful flowers and birds on it. If you want to see some more close-ups, I will link my Charming Escape first impression down below. But this is what the color story looks like. It's a pretty nice neutral color story with some rosy tones, some bronzy shimmers, and some green shimmers in here as well. So this is a pretty good eyeshadow palette. It's pretty easy to blend. It's not extremely pigmented, but pigmented enough. You can build it up. You can build different colors on each other. I feel like the bronzy shimmers in here are a little bit more impactful. The green ones are a little bit more dry. You can work with them, but I was hoping they would have a little bit more of oomph to them, but I can live with it. But I think if those green shimmers were a bit better, then maybe this would be higher. I actually used it on my eyes today. You can get quite a pretty look with it. You can deepen it up, but it's a bit on the softer side. And that's why it's a bit lower. It's not the most exciting palette. It's not the most interesting color story. It's not the most pigmented, but it's pretty nice. I like it. I would recommend it. It's just like pretty cute, and I think I would use it from time to time, but it's not like blowing me away. I think if you're someone who wants to do more basic looks, more soft looks, that wants to keep it all a little bit more soft, then this is definitely one I would recommend. Yeah, with this one, it's like the greens are what makes it special, what makes this interesting. But those are the eyeshadows that perform the worst, that aren't that great. So that's kind of why it's lower. The thing that makes it interesting also makes it a bit lower in quality. So yeah, this is one I wouldn't wholeheartedly say go get it, you need it. It's also a little bit more on the spendy side for drugstore-ish makeup, but I do like it. Next up, I put this Tower 28 Bronzino in the shade Suncoast. And this is a bronzer, a cream bronzer that I have been going back and forth on. Sometimes I use this and I'm like, it looks really pretty. Sometimes I use this and I'm like, it's too sticky, it's too smeary. And sometimes I use it and I'm like, it's too light. I can't really build it up to the intensity that I want without it looking extremely glowy and greasy. This is a pretty interesting formula. It's just a little bit more thick. It does dry down a little bit, but it is more thick to put on, and then it's like really, really extremely glowy. And it's not pure glow. It's definitely a shimmery bronzer. It is a subtle shimmer though. It's not like chunks of shimmer or like really visible individual particles. So it's not like that Catrice bronzer that it's too visible that it's shimmer. I do quite like the effect this gives, but it's not my favorite because it's so thick and sticky, and you kind of have to warm it up with your finger and apply it with your finger to really get some intensity out of this, and that's not always what I feel like doing. I love being able to use a brush, and yeah, I can do that with this one. I don't feel like it's extremely, extremely sticky to the point that things stick to it, but it's not a product that's really gonna dry down, it's really gonna be long lasting if anything touches it. I wouldn't wear this under a mask or anything like that. So maybe I would like it more if I didn't have to wear masks anymore at all. This is a product that I think not everybody is going to love. I think some people are really going to love this. People that really want a super glowy cheek, that don't mind if it's still kind of tacky, that don't mind if it dries down. But if you're someone who wants their makeup to last, that doesn't want to have to worry about their bronzer like rubbing off, then I wouldn't go for this one. I kind of have like a love-hate relationship with this bronzer, because and at the one hand, I quite like it and it's quite interesting, and it's something that I didn't have in my collection, and there are some intrigue there. I'm intrigued when it comes to this bronzer, but on the other hand, I'm also a bit scared of it, and I was kind of hoping that it would be easier to use and wear. This is a bronzer I think that in the future could go higher up, that I could start liking more or start liking less. It's a bit in the middle now, but I feel like if I use it more, I can possibly change my mind about it. But at least I told you what the characteristics are of this bronzer, so you can see for yourself if this would be something that you would like. The next spot goes to the Melt She's in Parties eyeshadow palette. I did a video trying this palette, and in that video I said I like the mattes but I don't love the shimmers. Since then I've done a few different looks and I'm gonna stick to that statement. I really really like the mattes in here. They're easy to blend. I don't have any problems with patchiness. Even this color just blends really easily. I feel like it's easy to use. I really love the undertones of these mattes, but these shimmers, they are a little bit on the soft side. They are pigmented but they are very satiny, and this Skeleton Kiss is just a little bit dry. This Strange Love, I was expecting a lot from this one. I was thinking that this was gonna be a very nice textured shimmer, but it isn't. It kind of is, but it also kind of isn't. It's like a really 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 soft version of a textured dimensional shimmer. So if you don't want something really impactful, really textured, but something just a little bit special, just a little bit different, then this is something you'd probably like. But I have tried so many special textured duochrome shimmers from other more affordable brands that I really love, and this just doesn't live up to that, isn't up to par. I can live with it. It's not like these shimmers are absolutely terrible. I can definitely incorporate them into looks and like the look, but I was just expecting a little bit more. And especially for such an expensive palette, I was thinking that these shimmers were gonna be more creamy, more shiny, and I was expecting that this was gonna blow me away and really give me that glowy, sparkly look. I have tried wetting them, I have tried using them with a glitter glue, but I feel like then they look a little bit too chunky and a little bit too like textured in a non-flattering way on my lids. I don't really like that, so I am happy with this palette, but I might try combining these mattes with other shimmers. It's just, it's not perfect, and I do think that I would recommend this, but I would say wait for a sale and only do it if you are in love with these mattes and don't feel like you have anything like it. Or if you are like, I don't really care about softer shimmers, you might like this. I was just expecting a little bit more. So next up we have the Charming Escape Silky Highlighter by the Kiko Limited Edition Collection. And usually the Kiko highlighters really, really, really blow me away. This is what the packaging looks like. It's really pretty. It had like a really pretty flower embossing. It's like a little bit worn off right now. Usually they really really blow me away, and this is a pretty highlighter. It's pretty nice, it's cute, I like the color, but it's not as blinding, it's not as easy to apply and just impressive as the other Kiko highlighters that I've tried. It's a different formula. It's not like a baked formula, it's more a bit creamy, so it's a bit harder to get on your brush, and then when you apply it, it's a bit of a softer highlight. You have to build it up, you have to get quite a bit on your brush. It kind of depends on what you have underneath, if this is gonna look very glowy or just more soft and subtle. So it's not that this is a bad product, I do like it, but it is a bit more subtle than Kiko highlighters usually are. So I have worn this a few times and I have really liked it, but I just am more of a fan of highlighters that I don't have to go into the pan so much to get a glowing effect. I like it when I can just go in a little bit, just apply it and I'm done. It feels like I need a little bit more work to get the look that I want. But if you are someone who likes a little bit more of a subtle highlight, then I would definitely recommend this one. By the way, this is the one in the shade Sunrise Apricot. It's pretty, it's really pretty, but it's just, if I compare this to the other Kiko highlighters that I have that I absolutely love, then this is just one that isn't I almost dropped it. Oh my god. Okay. Whew. Nothing happened. Price is averted. Okay. So when I compare this to the other Kiko highlighters that are like my absolute favorites, then I just like this one a little bit less, and that's why it's a little bit lower. And if this were more like the formula of the other highlighters by Kiko, then it probably would be a bit higher. It's not bad, I would still recommend it, but I think if you want a more glowy result, then I would go with some of the other highlighters, some more baked highlighters. This is more, I don't know, it's like not like putty, but kind of. It's kind of putty, it's kind of creamy. And those types of formulas are always a little bit harder to apply, I feel. You have to apply them a certain way, kind of build them up. So that's kind of what's going on with this one. Next up, the next spot is going to the Catrice Natural 10 Serum. This is a serum that you use for a few days and then it gives your face a little bit of a tan. This, I feel, really works for me. It gives me a tan in like 2-3 days. I don't have to use a lot of this. It doesn't have like the perfect ingredients for my skin, but because I only have to use it for a few days and then the effect last for a few weeks, I feel, maybe a week to 2 weeks, because I don't have to use it that much, I don't really mind. It's not like terrible, but I believe there's perfume in this. My skin doesn't really react well to perfume, but because I don't have to use it a lot, it works pretty fast. I don't really have any problems with that in this product. I quite like it. I quite like the application process. It goes into the skin very easily. It's not too greasy. I like the look. I like how it looks after the tan has developed. And I think this is going to be a product that I'm going to be using more in like the winter, if I'm not tan at all anymore, and then kind of like blend it down on my neck so my face doesn't look as pale as it sometimes does. Although nowadays I'm not that pale in winter, actually. I'm not that pale. I used to not go outside a lot. Like, even in summer, I didn't used to go outside a lot. When I was a teenager, I was just sitting inside during summer vacation or watching series, like binge watching series, but nowadays I go out for walks, I go do things, I go outside, so I get a little bit more tan. But still, I think it's nice to have a product like this to just use for a few days in the winter to kind of make your skin look a little bit more bronzy. So yeah, I quite like this product. It's a good product, it's decent, I like it, I would recommend it. I think it's a good affordable option when it comes to these gradual tan serums. So the next spot in this ranking, I think I wouldn't have expected this to be so high before I tried all these eyeshadow palettes, but I think, yeah, this is gonna be the best eyeshadow palette that I tried this month. Now I'm kind of giving away the other things, but this is the best eyeshadow palette that I've tried. This is the Catrice Slim Eyeshadow Palette, Pro Slim Eyeshadow Palette in Natural Spirit. This is a pretty cute kind of fall type color story. That's the reason why I wanted to try this. I thought the colors in here looked really cute. The shimmers in here are nice. They are the nicest shimmers for sure from all these palettes. They are really basic, but nice and creamy, nice and shiny. I really, really think they are a good, decent formula. Nothing special, nothing textured, but I can really appreciate just a good basic shiny shimmer. Then we have these matte shades. Some of them are a little bit more lightly pigmented, some of them are a little bit more soft, but if you go into the darker shades, especially this one, you can get quite an impactful look. And these darker shades are really easy to blend, and they are so easy to blend in a way that it kind of looks like you are wearing multiple shadows in the crease. If you just take one of these darker shades and just blend, then you can get a really nice, easy look. And that's the way I like to use this palette if I want the look to be a little bit more impactful. So I actually really liked all the looks that I did with this palette. I really, really think it's good quality. It's not the best palette ever, but it's a nice color story, nice quality. It's a bit softer, but I don't mind that. Sometimes I like being able to just blend something out really easily, not think about it too much. Mattes not being too pigmented in a way that you can't really do anything else but a really, really dark, smoky look. I just really, really like this palette. I think it's good quality. It's a bit basic, but I really think the color story is quite nice and inspiring. I personally, I've loved doing looks with it. Just if you're someone who really likes really, really crazy, impactful looks, if you're someone who likes special textured shimmers, maybe this isn't for you. But if you're someone who likes to do looks that are a little bit on the colorful side, but you still want it to be soft and wearable, then I would definitely recommend this palette. So the next thing is actually an eyeshadow that I don't know if I have shown this in a video. I don't think I've shown this in a video. So this is the Catrice eyeshadow in the shade Golden Leaf. In their update, they have released a bunch of these type of single eyeshadows that are kind of like shimmers with sprinkles in them, and then you kind of like mix that and it mixes together on your eye. This is something I think I should show a little bit more up close. Can you see? It kind of has the sprinkles here. It's really cute, and this is a beautiful shimmer. Let me just quickly swatch it. It's really creamy, really shiny, and it has a green to gold duochrome. Just look at how shiny this is. Look at that. It's so beautiful. It has a bit of a dark green base. Then it also is a bit of a, you can also see a little bit of a light green and gold shift in there. It's really, really pretty. I think this is a gorgeous eyeshadow. I think this is so beautiful, and it's also really nice to combine with that Natural Spirit palette, because this is a little bit more of a special shadow. You can take the look to another level and make it a little bit more special. This eyeshadow I think is really interesting. It's a good quality, and I think maybe I'm gonna check out if they have some other interesting shades in this, because if I have a really beautiful interesting single shadow in the packaging like this, I used to not be the one to use that, but nowadays I'm actually someone who likes to wear those types of eyeshadows from time to time. It's actually really strange, because for years and years and years I didn't reach for eyeshadows like this, but if it's like a really interesting shade, I will reach for it. I highly recommend it. It's so creamy, it's so shiny, it's like, it's a beautiful color, beautiful texture. I think this is really worth your money. It's such an affordable shade, but still like really interesting and pretty. I think Catrice and Essence, they can sometimes do really pretty single eyeshadows, especially the Catrice mattes up until now I've really liked, and then the Essence shimmers, but they can sometimes kind of surprise me and do something really, really good. And this is definitely an example of that. Next up in this ranking, I have the Kika Milano Charming Escape Silky Blush. Once again, we have beautiful packaging. This silky blush is a little bit smaller than the highlighter. And this is in the shade Tasty Peach. It's a quite a bright, glowy blush. It has a nice amount of pigmentation, I feel. You can really, really tell on the cheeks that you're kind of, you're wearing this bright coral shade. It's quite warm. It's a different shade for me. It's a different shade in my collection. I don't really have anything like this. I just really liked this baked formula. I really liked the glow that it gave on the skin. A very natural, really pretty color. It's just a really, really nice blush. It's just what I would expect from Kiko. They do really nice baked blushes, and this is just an interesting shade. I really, really like this one. I don't really have anything special to say about this. It's just a good blush with a glowy finish. It has a nice bright color. I like it. It's good. I really like it. Next up is actually a bit of a surprise, a bit of a different product, I feel. A bit of a product that I didn't expect to love as much. This is the Catrice Blush Box Glowing Multicolor in the shade Warm Soul. I tried this out in the Catrice Try On Haul as well. I tried the Coral Light on one cheek, and I tried this one on the other cheek, and I really, really liked that other cheek. After that, I've used this quite a few times. I kind of had to say to myself, don't use it too much. You still have other products to try and to test. So if I would have had the chance, and I would have used it even more. It looks kind of powdery in the pan, but then when you swirl it all around and you apply it to the cheeks, it's a beautiful glowy blush without any shimmer. It's just a beautiful natural glow, a really nice kind of warm pinkish color to it. I really, really like the effect this has on the skin. It's a bit more highlighty than that Kiko blush. And I personally just really like glowy blushes, and I was really impressed with how glowy this actually was, but in a way that's really wearable, sophisticated, nothing crazy, nothing shimmery, just really easy to wear. So I really, really like this one. It's also really affordable. It's a great product. I really, really like this. For spot number four, I put this Kika Milano Charming Escape Luxurious Shiny Lipstick. This is such a beautiful component. Like, look at this bullet. It's so pretty. The bright pink with the gold. It's gorgeous. Then the shade that I got is a nice nude shade, I believe. This is a shade 01. They never put the actual names on the bullet for some reason. I don't know, but this is the lightest shade in the collection. And it's a beautiful, shiny nude lipstick. A gorgeous formula, not too smeary. So nice and shiny. I really, really love this shade. It's a little bit on the warm nude side, but still light enough to really, really work for me. I really like this. This is a product that I expected to love and did, but I just can't deny how good Kiko Milano does these shiny lipsticks. They do really, really beautiful shiny lipsticks. And this, once again, is just a beautiful, beautiful shade. And I really feel like this adds a lot to my collection, even though I already have some really nice shiny lipsticks. And just this packaging, I think, is so beautiful. This collection, they really knocked it out of the park. They really did so good with designing this packaging. Sometimes Kiko Milano can make the outer box look very interesting, but the packaging itself, they can make that look a little bit boring. But this really, really is so beautiful, and I feel like this product is just perfect. It's just perfect the way it is. I love it. It's no surprise. It's nothing out of the ordinary, but that's also good sometimes. That's also nice to have sometimes, that you expect to love something and you actually do. For the third spot, I put this Milk Makeup Cream Bronzer in the shade Baked. I got the mini. And yeah, this is a cult classic. This is a product that I've heard so many people about, and I've been getting into cream. So I thought, you know what? Let's try this mini. And this is a beautiful product. Beautiful color. It's kind of neutral, leaning a little bit warm, but not too warm. It's really easy to blend out, really easy to use. I think it's a great effect on the skin. I don't feel like it looks extremely matte. It just looks really natural and creamy. This is just a really great product, really easy to use. This is what I expect from a cream product. If a cream product is like this, just so easy to apply and blend out, then I'm into it. Then I love it. I don't like when cream products are too pigmented at first and then hard to blend out or really patchy. And this is just a product you can't really go wrong. I feel like it's a really nice cream bronzer for if you're just getting into creams, you don't know where to start, you don't want to use products that are too like scary and intimidating, then I would definitely recommend this one. I do have to say, with this month, with this ranking, I didn't feel like there was one clear winner. Sometimes I do have one clear winner, one product that I've used so much that was the best ever. But I feel like with this top five, they could be interchanged. I really liked all of these, was really impressed with all of these. And I feel like if I were in a different mood, this could kind of like be changed around. So that is what's going on with this ranking right now. The bad products like were really clear to me this time. That also doesn't always happen. Sometimes I like everything. So with these top products, I'm not like, this is the best for sure. On number two, we have the Glowgasm Beauty Light Wand by Charlotte Tilbury. This was my first time trying Charlotte Tilbury. This was finally in stock and it was on sale. So I was like, you know what? I will try it. So this is what it looks like. I think we all know this product. And it's just a really beautiful bronzy pink, a beautiful shiny glowy cream blush. I feel like it's easy to use, it's easy to blend out, but the most important thing about this is the effect, that it looks kind of like sunburned, like that rosy shade. I really love it. And then that glowiness, I think it looks so good on the cheeks. One time I used it, I used quite a bit. It gets really, really glowy, kind of metallic. But another time I used just a little bit and kept it a little bit more soft, and even then it still looks really pretty, a little bit still glowy, but just a little bit more subdued and toned down. And I feel like it stays on long enough. I really like it. I definitely can't wait to use this more and to do even more looks with this one. I really love glowy cheek products like this. I think they give an effect that you can't really get with something that is powder. And then it's like, this is really worth it. This is really worth using a product like a cream product like this. So it's a great product. I like it. I get the hype. It's a good blush, but it's a little bit expensive. So wouldn't say that you need it, but it is something very interesting and different, I think. So for the first place, I actually have two products in one because I bought a second color because I like this so much. So in my first impression of the Catrice new products, I actually tried this Holiday Skin Luminous Bronzer in the shade 010 Summer in the City. And it's a bit light. You can see it. It shows up on me, but it's a bit too light actually. It does bronze me, but it's a little bit soft. But I did really like the effect of it. It looks luminous in a kind of creamy, natural way. It's easy to blend. It's not blotchy at all. It's really like smooth. And I really, really love the effect of this bronze. So after that, I was kind of like waiting for the other bronzer color to drop as well. I don't know why they didn't drop that right away. It's a bit weird. But I didn't really see it online at first. That's why I bought the lighter shade. But then I found the deeper shade. This is the same product, like the same bronzer, but in the shade 020 of the Island. This is a bit deeper, but nothing too crazy, nothing too deep for me. I feel like they should invest in having some better inclusive lines when it comes to their bronzers. Their bronzers don't really go deeper than this, and I get that they're a drugstore brand and they've been doing this like this for such a long time, but I think it's time that Catrice and Essence as well, that they come out with some deeper bronzers. And I believe their foundation lines are also not very inclusive usually. So I wish that they would think about that more. I guess this happens a lot with drugstore brands, but I feel like we're past that. We're way past that. We shouldn't be like that anymore. They shouldn't be like that anymore. But okay. This is the deeper shade. It's Off to the Island. I really, really love the formula. And this shade is still really easy to use and wear for me. And it's just a little bit better for me right now with how my skin is looking right now, the tan that I have right now. But I think that the other shade I will probably use more in winter. So this is kind of what I'm saying, what I've been telling you. Catrice does do very good cheek products. The blush, the bronzers that I just showed you, those are great. But the things that I showed you at the beginning, those are not that great. I would say they're pretty bad. So they can do really good cheek products, and I'm used to them doing good cheek products, but I would say watch a review and also kind of look at the packaging. Usually when they do kind of cheap looking cardboard packaging like this, it happens a lot that isn't the best quality. So I feel like after years and years and years of buying Essence and Catrice, I've kind of developed this sixth sense for when their products are going to be good or bad because of the way it looks in the photos and the way the packaging looks. So I was kind of thinking probably that Coral Eyes palette wasn't gonna be good, but I was still interested because it was a new product and I had hope. Some of this worked out great, some of this didn't work out as well. It happens. So that's gonna be everything for my new makeup ranking. Let me know in the comments if you've tried any of these products. Did you agree with me or maybe not? Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like this video if you liked it. And don't forget to subscribe. And I will see you in my next one. Bye bye.